Welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. Now, I did start recording this, but sadly we got interrupted. Now, what I was talking about in the previous video was the transformation of suits, transforming these into perhaps making them into new by adding contrasting patties onto dupattas and onto daman of kameez. This one I've already done. I'm going to show the video the tutorial I'm going to do with these will be showing how to meter the corners and how to apply the putty on and what to do in what way to make it easy as possible. It's not always easy to tackle stuff like this. So this is just the one I had to trial it out before I went on to complete the others or tackle the others. So the next one that we're going to be doing is this one. We've been given that dupatta belongs to this one. I've got to work out what belongs to what as well, and what I've matched and what's been given with what. Okay, so this one, I'm going to give you a typical example. This one is with this. And it's the similar kind of concept, but it's in the pink and some of the colors has been picked up. So we're going to be applying that to the bottom of this. We're going to be applying it on the sides of the dupatta, just leaving a little bit of this visible. And then on the ends, this is one that I already did a few months ago for someone. And now it's come back to have something further added to it. So we're going to be trimming the bottom hem of this with this, and then hopefully trim the sides of the dupatta with this. So that one is to go with that one. And I do think this lace was also bought. No, I'm going to apply the lace on that one. Okay, so that's with that one. Then this one is to be trimmed off with the velvet at the bottom, and a velvet and a pearl lace. So that one is to go with that one. Generally what happens is matching up what goes with what actually takes forever. It's a very, very hard process and a difficult one to tackle. So with this one, we're supposed to be doing a contrast of two colors of the piping, and then top these off with this lace. Like this. Now for the kameez I think that's going to be fine, but for the dupatta that may present a problem. So I think we're just going to do the one color with the dupatta, but perhaps two colors with the kameez, and probably apply this lace on with the dupatta. Okay, so that is going to be my reinvent for all these dresses. Before I go, there is something else that I want to show you. Any laces, any pattiyan that you apply, always pre-test them. One of the problems that I encountered whilst I was just getting ready to apply this on, and I don't know what I've done with it now, was one of these laces, we applied it onto the daman, and without thinking, went ahead and fully applied it on, and as soon as we tried to press it and iron it, the border on it just shrunk and withered into basically nothing. It was totally ruined, and what it meant was we had to unpick this was the lace. Now it pre-shrunk, and basically what happened was it actually tore to bits. Some laces are just not stable. When you iron them, they actually, the metallic thread shrinks, And so always pre-test all your laces by perhaps ironing a corner of them. If they shrink, pre-shrink them before applying them to your garment, including the borders. Sometimes the metallic threads in these borders, I know it presents extra work, but that extra work is better than actually applying the this onto the garment and then having to unstitch it. That's exactly what happened on this dress. We had no idea that that was what was going to happen. So we applied it on top of as a trim on top of the damen, and next thing, as soon as we pressed it, it just shrunk into a small space and was totally ruined. I'm sure as a machinist, you know, who any of you who are full-time machinists would have already experienced that, because we don't tend to think, we go, and it's happened to us a few times, but each time it happens, you think, you know what, for next time I'm going to be wiser. And this is one of the things with sewing, that it's not, you know, sometimes the mind just sways back into not thinking far ahead. Always pre-plan, plan ahead. Maybe these words repeatedly being repeated over and over again will sink into your head. Never mind sinking into your head, they don't even actually lodge into my own head. Often even we forget, I forget, and we'd go and make the same mistake over again. So these are just some of the points to bear in mind, and it's problems like these that actually put you off sewing. So when you experience, I mean, this really, really, you know, upset me when I when we finished making this, and then the lace just got ruined. It completely threw me off. And that is that then you have to go and unpick every single part, and once it's unpicked, the result second time around is not always the same. So always pre-prepare. You know, preparation is a key ingredient to getting anything right. So whenever you buy laces, just test them out to make sure that they're not the shrinking type. I've had some on designer suits which were, you know, and we've sewn garments where we've had problems with them. So be wise, be cautious, watch the videos fully. If there's anything that's been repeated, it is for your own guidance only. I don't like to do the same videos over and over again, but sometimes because it's something that I've come across and I want to relay the message to the viewers, I actually opt to address that problem over and over again. So make sure to reinvent all your outfits. I mean, we've had, you see, I do part tutorials and then I end up remembering other stuff along the way. Now you see, these are all the type of suits, right, that have been pre-embroidered. That's on pure silk, beautiful embroidery, but the problem is that this is another outfit that has been you know, embroidered, but it's not the right fashion. So because of the fashion thing, it's been chucked to a side. I will probably like to do like a reinvent thing on that, because this would make a beautiful dress, but because of the fact that it's short, coming out short, you know what, and the damen is originally, when this was embroidered, believe it or not, this damen was too wide, and now the damen is too small. It's funny, fashion is a funny thing, and I'm gonna address that in another video where it's gonna be who dictates fashion. So I'd like to have viewers' replies on that. Who dictates fashion? You know, who dictates fashion for you? I don't. I certainly don't dictate fashion. You know, I am just a follower, and I think majority of us are followers. But watch the video on who dictates fashion, where I'm going to try and address what is fashion, and you know, how do we go about wearing what other people are suggesting to us. So you all take care, have a wonderful day, and I will see you again very, very soon.